I'm Kevin Enge. I'm a research herpetologist with the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. I'm here with Dr. Travis Thomas with the University of Florida's Nature Coast Biological Station. We're on the upper Suwannee River near White Springs. Just got done checking 12 traps for the Suwannee alligator snapping turtle. In 2014, Travis was the lead author on a paper describing it as a distinct species, which is now state threatened. We caught two turtles in the 12 traps, which is pretty typical for this far up river. It's a blackwater stream, very tannic water, low pH and low biological productivity. Further downstream in the middle part of the Suwannee, when you get groundwater and spring input, much more productive. We'll average 2 to 3 times more turtles in the traps and a lot larger turtles. A lot of our males are over 100 pounds there.
115 pound turtle.
And we've got a really skewed sex ratio, at least 4 males, usually for every 1 female. So, of the 2 turtles we caught today, one's really exciting. This one right here, it's a recapture, and it was also a turtle that we had transmitted in and we tracked back in 2013. Here, there's a transmitter still on the back. We'll be removing it, and you can see we've got some drill holes identified. It also has a pit tag in its tail, so we'll know exactly which turtle it is. And getting these recaptures are what we're really looking for, because we can get growth data, survival data, and eventually we can do get better population models and detect population trends. So we're going to be establishing a long-term monitoring study at 3 of our former 12 sites. I'll show you the other turtle we caught. It's a larger turtle, but still not that super big. There's 3 channel catfish in the trap with it. These traps are 4-foot diameter hoop net traps, and we just bait them with fish and go out and catch some turtles.